hand communication is commonplace on any modern engine, and being able to decode the signals from that CAN bus can be quite difficult for us in the aftermarket industry. I'm Andre from the High Performance Academy, and behind us we've got one of the jet boats from the guys at Shot Over Jet here in Queenstown. These boats have just been equipped with a new Hyundai 3-litre common rail diesel turbo engine, and a bit of a trial moving away from the older 350 Chevs that they used to run. Now, part of the system is getting some data through to the MoTeC SDL3 dashes that all of the boats are equipped with. The engines themselves are controlled by a Hyundai ECU, but the team at Shot Over need to be able to see the data and record it, so they've got some indication of how the boat's operating, how the driver's operating, and also some parameters around the engine's health. So our job was to decode the information being sent by the Hyundai ECU via the CAN bus and decode that into a format that the MoTeC SDL3 could read. Decoding this CAN bus data can be a little bit tricky and a little bit time consuming. We start with a CAN bus sniffer, which is a piece of hardware and software that allows us to see the data being sent on the CAN bus. So this shows us the data as well as what address on the CAN bus the data is being sent at. After that, we still need a way of decoding this information because it is simply a bunch of hexadecimal numbers with very little meaning. So the way we do that is by finding out which sensor information is being sent on what address. This is a simple case of trial and error by unplugging a sensor and seeing what particular piece of information on the CAN bus changes. We're using a Hyundai G-Scan scan tool as well, and that tool gives us the actual data values. So for example, if we're looking at a parameter like engine coolant temperature, we can see on the G-Scan exactly what the coolant temperature reading that the ECU is seeing is. We can then compare that to the raw hexadecimal data being sent for that parameter, and we can provide some scaling data to convert the raw hexadecimal value into a meaningful value for engine coolant temperature. While we're doing this, we can use a resistor wheel to adjust the coolant temperature reading, or for that matter, the readings of any of the sensors that rely on a variable resistance or a variable voltage. And again, using the input from the G-Scan scan tool, we can confirm that the values we're actually seeing on the CAN bus are correct. Once we know the address that a certain sensor is being transmitted on, as well as the scaling data for that particular piece of information, it's a reasonably straightforward process to create a CAN template inside the MoTeC SDL3 to receive that information. From there, we can use that data to display on the dash what's happening with the engine, as well as provide warnings in case any part of the engine's operation goes outside of the parameters the team are happy with. On top of that, of course, we can also data log all of those parameters into the dash for later analysis.